Hi, good morning to one and all. Myself, A. Ramajanayalu. In previous lecture, we discussed about different types of special casting process, what is application of special casting process, and advantages and disadvantages of special casting process. In this lecture, we will discuss about casting defects and remedies. What is casting defect? Why it occurs? During the casting process, there are many different reasons for the casting defect. At the time of preparation of molding sand, during the core preparation, during the melting process and pouring of molten metal and solidification process. These are the different reasons of a casting defect. We'll discuss one by one. That is, it is an unwanted irregularities that appear in the casting during metal casting process. That is unwanted irregularities, because during the casting process there is a solidification time and pouring time is there, already discussed in a gating system design. This is the that is gating ratio and pouring time, all these will affect on the casting reasons for the casting defects. There is various reasons of sources which are responsible for the defects in the casting of metal. That is, coming to, there are different types of casting defects. That is, here there are number of casting defects are there. That all these defects can be grouped into six categories. That is, the first one is gas porosity. In these defects, that is blowholes, open holes and pinholes, these are come under the gas porosity. These are the developed due to the gas entrapped during the pouring of molten metal into the mold cavity. It is the main defect, that is gas porosity, gas developed during the pouring of molten metal and the gases released by mold and molten metal. Next, shrinkage defect. After during the solidification process, shrinkage will occur. It will mainly occur in non-ferrous materials. Next, mold material defects. Mold material defects is nothing but it is mainly based on the molding material. Molding material is nothing but molding sand at the time of preparation of sand and during the ramming process, and the permeability and refractiveness of the sand, all these will affect on the casting process. The casting defects will occur due to the mold material defects. Next, metallurgical defects. Due to the metallurgical defect means it is mainly based on the pouring of molten metal, and that is type of metal we used and the type of melting, all these come under these defects. That is hot tears and hot spot. Next, coming to pouring metal defects. That is it is come under the time of pouring of molten metal into the mold cavity, and that is pouring time and gating ratio, all these affect. That is cold shed, misrun and slag inclusion. Next, last one is casting shape defects, that is shift or mismatch bracking. At the time of preparation of molding process, in some cases the mold should be shifted at the potting surface. Due to this, the shape will be changed from the exact shape to the completed shape or required shape. It will change from, that is mismatch at the potting surface. In some cases wrapping will occur. Wrapping means, suppose you have to manufacture a U shape or V shape, at the edges of the object will be deflected towards the inward or outwards. These are nothing but wrapping of the object. These are the different types of casting defects. We will discuss one by one. That is, first one is gas porosity, casting defect and causes. That is, gas porosity occurs when the metal traps gas, that is mostly nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, during the casting process. At the time of pouring, some gases will escape into the mold cavity. Due to this gas, some air bubbles will form. Due to this, some defects, casting defects will come. That is known as gas porosity. That is, when the casting cools and solidifies, bubbles forms because the solid form of the metal that can hold much gas as a gas liquid form, that will form air bubbles. Due to this air bubbles, the strength of the casting object will be reduced. At the time of application of load, it will fail easily due to this defect. Next, these bubbles appear on the casting as round circular cavities or holes. In some these gas porosity mainly cast into three rays, that is pinholes, subsurface holes and blowholes. The blowholes is nothing but in that is form on the surface of the object. Subsurface holes, it is formed inside the object. Next, pinholes are the pinholes is nothing but it is small holes, that is pinholes. It is formed at the some area in a number of holes at the same surface at the same point. These are about gas porosity casting defects. Next, first types of gas porosity. There are three different types of gas defects. That is, first one is pinholes, subsurface holes, and open holes. Coming to pinholes. In this diagram, we will observe here. Here, some pinholes are formed. Here, small pinholes are formed and grouped at the same point. These are developed due to the gas porosity. It will be we'll find out these defects by using the naked eye. That is, pinholes are also sometimes referred to as porosities, as very tiny holes, that is about 2 mm usually, found in the cope box, that is upper part of the molding flask known as cope, and part of the mold in the poorly vented black pockets. Next, they usually appear in large number of together, either at the surface or just below the surface of the casting. Next, they are always visible to the naked eye and do not require to identify these defects by using we did not require any equipment to identify these defects. Next, coming to subsurface blowhole. These are formed at inside of the metal. Blowholes are simply blows or larger cavities than the pinholes, is named as subsurface holes. Okay, next. A subsurface hole appear on the inside of the casting, usually is not visible until after the machine. Sometimes we have to be machined for after the preparation of solidification process. In that case, at the time of machining, we will identify some holes inside the metal, is known as subsurface blowhole. Next, subsurface blowhole are difficult to defect before machining, require harmonic, ultrasonic, magnetic or x-ray analysis. Next, coming to open holes. These blowholes appear on the surface of the cast are easier to detect than subsurface holes because these defects are formed on the surface of the object. For that case, we have to easy to identify. We can easily identify by using the naked eye. These defects cannot require the any special equipment. Okay, these are the diagrammatic representation of the open holes and blow holes formed in an object. Okay, next, coming to causes of gas porosity. What are the different causes for the formation of gas porosity? That is, poor venting or of mold and cores. Suppose during the molding process, we have to provide a vents. Due to vents, the gases formed in the mold cavity is easily escaped due to the from the vent holes. That is, poor venting or mold and cores will cause the gas porosity. Next, insufficient drying of mold and cores. Scarce or shallow blowholes that appear on a flat surface while blisters or scars covered with a thin layer of the metal. Next, excessive moisture content of molding sand. Suppose at the time of preparation we are mixing of sand and water. After the preparation of mold, some moisture content in the mold, by drying the mold, will reduce the moisture content in the sand. Suppose in some case excessive moisture content of the mold will form in the molding. It will be the main cause of the gas porosity. Next, inadequate gas permeability of mold sand. That is, permeability is one of the factor for the molding sand. and core. For that case, permeability have to use more permeability to escape the gases developed in the mold cavity. Next, how to prevent the gas porosity or remedies for gas porosity? That is, incorporate good fluxing and melting practice. Melt the metal in a vacuum in an environment of low solubility gases or under a flux that prevents contact with the air. During the melting process, we are using flux material. These fluxes will melt the unwanted material or dissolve the unwanted material in the molten metal. By using the flux, we can prevent this gas porosity. Next, increase gas permeability of sand. That is, coarser sands have a higher permeability compared to normal sand. Next, increase permeability of mold and cores. Allow air and gas to escape from the mold cavity. This permeability, we have to increase the permeability of the mold and cores. Allow air and gas to escape from the mold cavity before the pouring of molten metal. It is one of the prevention of gas porosity. Next, dry out molds and cores before using the use and store dry. Because by drying the cores and mold, we can reduce the moisture content in the mold. Okay. Next, increase rate of solidification by reducing metal temperature during the casting. During the casting, we have to provide a chills or we have to reduce the temperature by transferring the temperature from the molten metal to the surrounding walls. By that, we have to reduce the gas porosity. Next, coming to shrinkage casting defects and causes. What shrinkage defects occur mainly at the time of solidification. During the solidification process, the liquid, the molten metal in the form of liquid, it will convert into solidification. That is, the temperature value decreases during the solidification process. The volume of the casting object will reduce. Due to this, shrinkage of the object will form. Due to shrinkage, porosity appears with angular edges compared to round surface of the gas porosity. Next, large shrinkage cavities can undermine the integrity of casting and may cause it eventually break under stress. During the application of loads, a larger stress will act on the at the area of defect. That is, the stress concentration will more at the point of defect. Next, coming to types of shrinkage defects. That is, open shrinkage defects and closed shrinkage defects. Coming to open shrinkage defects, these are all open to atmosphere. Air compensate at the shrinkage cavity forms. It mainly forms in the pipes or open to shrinkage defect that form at the surface and burrow into the casting. That is, due to these defect, cave surface and shallow open shrinkage defect are formed across the surface of the casting observed in this diagram. Next, closed shrinkage defect, also known as shrinkage porosity. Closed shrinkage defect forms within the casting. Suppose macro shrinkage can be viewed by the naked eye, but micro shrinkage we use X-rays or ultrasonic or different inspection methods. But in case of this defect, the closed shrinkage defects usually appear at the hot spots or isolated pools or a hot liquid. These are the areas the formation of closed shrinkage. Next, it is the diagrammatic representation of shrinkage defects. It is the open shrinkage defect and it is the a closed shrinkage defect. In this, macro shrinkage form here, and this is the micro shrinkage, and micro porosity will form due to the shrinkage, and it is known as shrinkage defect. The closed one, and this is the open one. Okay, next, coming to what are the causes of the shrinkage defect. That is, alloys always shrink when changing from molten to solid. This is because of density of the casting alloys is more in the molten state is lower than the solid state. Generally, the shrinkage defect is lesser in the pure metals compared to the alloy metals. In alloy metals, the shrinkage defect is very high compared to the pure metals because of lower density. Because of lower density of the casting alloy, the shrinkage will form. Next, you should expect some shrinkage during solidification. Okay. Next, factor a shrinkage allowance into the provided design before the cast. Based on the metal and the weight of the casting, we have to provide the shrinkage allowance. In shrinkage, there are mainly two different types of shrinkage, that is liquid shrinkage and solid shrinkage. The liquid shrinkage will be compensated by using the riser, molten metal stored in the riser. But in case of solid shrinkage, we have to compensate the solid shrinkage by providing the shrinkage allowance at the time of designing a pattern or making a pattern. Next, remedies of shrinkage defect, that is you can prevent shrinkage casting defects by improving the overall casting structure, that is pattern preparation or molding or type of molding material and designing a runner system with riser that ensures a continuous flow of molten metal. Next, increase local heat dissipation by inserting chills, cooling ribs or cooling coils. Next, reduce casting temperature to limit the total volume defect. These are the remedies of shrinkage defects. Next, coming to mold material casting defects and causes. Mold material casting defects mainly cause of molding materials. Molding materials is nothing but sand, silica. These are the different types of mold material we are using, that is metal. Okay, mold material casting defects are related to the mold material, which is most commonly sand, that is cuts and washes, fusion, runout, swells, drops, rat tails, veneers and buckles, and metal penetration. These are the different types of defects. That is, first coming to cuts and washes. Cuts and washes are areas of excessive metal. These appear when the molten metal erodes the molding sand. At the time of pouring molten metal at high velocity, turbulence will create. These will erode the mold material in the casting. A cut appears as low projection along the surface of the drag face, decrease in height as it extends from one side to another side. Observed in diagram here, in the bottom of the casting, one small wash will create by eroding the mold material. Is known as cuts and washes. Next, causes of cuts and washes. That is, cuts and washes can be caused by molten metal flowing at a high velocity, causing too much metal to flow through the gate. Next, remedies for cuts and washes. You can prevent the cuts and washes easiest by designing the gating system properly, improving mold and core strength. Next, adding more binders to the facing of core sand. These are the remedies for the cuts and washes. Next, coming to fusion. Fusion occurs when sand grains fuse with molten metal, that is, it appears at the crust with a brittle, glassy appearance firmly adhered to the cast. Observed in diagram, here the casting, that is fusion, will develop for the casting and at the bottom section, because if the sand grains fuse with the molten metal. Next, causes of fusion, that is, there are two main factors can cause the fusion, that is low refractoriness of the clay or sand. Next, too high pouring temperature of molten metal. These are the two main factors for the fusion. Prevention of fusion, that is refractoriness, is the ability of the molding material, that is to resist the temperature of the liquid. Do not fuse with the metal, that is silica sand, at the highest refractoriness compared to the remaining materials. For that, at the time of preparation of molding material, we choose the sand with high refractoriness factor. Next, coming to improving the refractoriness of the molding material and reducing the pouring temperature of the molten metal with help of to prevent the fusion. Next, swells or the enlargement of the casting. Swells typically take a shape of a slight smooth bulge on the vertical surfaces of the casting, because vertical surfaces are very smooth compared to the remaining surfaces. At the time of pouring molten metal, it will enlarge the casting vertical walls. In this diagram, we will observe the swells. Okay. Next, coming to cause and prevention of swells. That is, swell is usually caused by improper or soft ramming of the mold or low strength mold. Next, mold should be built to withstand liquid metal pressure. Otherwise, the mold wall may be given way to or move back, causing the swelling. Next, using a strong, properly rammed prevents swells. At the time of preparation of molding process, we will do the ramming process in a hard way. So in soft ramming and hot ramming, we will prefer only hard ramming to prevent the swelling of the casting object. Next, coming to drops. Drops occurs when piece of sand fall into the metal, causing metal casting when it's still liquid drops. That is observed in the diagram. Here, drops will occur above the surface of the object. That is, at the time of molding process, some amount of mold particle, it will falls on the molten metal. Due to this, some extra surface will form, or some bubbles, bubble type structure. It is known as drop. Next, causes and prevention of drops. That is, for potential causes for drops and their prevention. That is, low sand strength. Use sand of higher strength. If this your culprit, that is, we have at the time of selection of molding sand, we have to select the sand with high strength. By selecting the high strength molding sand, we will prevent this defect. That is, next, soft ramming. Provide hard ramming. At the time of ramming, we have to provide the hard ramming, because this the strength of the molding sand will increase. Insufficient fluxing of molten metal. That is, properly fluxing molten metal removes the impurities. During the melting process, we have to provide the flux. These flux will help the removing the unwanted or unmelted particles in the pouring metal. Next, insufficient reinforce of sand projections in the cope. That is, reinforce sand projections using the nails or gaggers to fix the issue. Next, coming to rat tails, veneers and buckles. These are the form when the irregular lines or cracks on the casting, when the surface of the molding sand buckles. This is mainly the rat tails occurs at the surface of the bottom part of the casting. Next, buckles are more severe from the rat tails. Observed in diagram, these are the rat tails, veneers and buckles in the casting surface. Next, causes and prevention of rat tails. That is, rat tails and buckles occur when excessive heat of the metal causes. During the pouring metal, it is having more temperature than the required. For that case, these rat tails will form and to expand the molding sand. Next, poor expansion properties of the sand. At low temperature, the sand will expand and it form the rat tails. Next, a hot pouring temperature reduces pouring temperature of metal. Next, poor mold design. Next, the mold also should not be too hot. Okay. Next, coming to metal penetration. Metal penetration is nothing but at the time of molding process, the metal will penetrate into the molding sand due to the high pressure or high strength, low strength in the molding sand. It is the diagrammatic representation of metal penetration. Next, coming to causes of metal penetration. That is, use of sand with low strength and high permeability. Use of large or coarse sand grain. Suppose if you use small grains, means we will prevent these defects. That is, the coarser sand grains, the more surface and penetration. Next, lack of mold wash. Next, soft ramming of sand. These are the causes of this defect. Next, coming to remedies for metal penetration. Next, to prevent the metal penetration by fix these areas, use high strength and low grain size and low permeability and hot warming of sand. These are the preventions for the metal penetration. Ensure the protective barrier against metal penetration by coating the surface of the molds with a mold wash. By this, we have to prevent these metal penetration. Next, coming to, you can typically remove metal penetration by grinding down the rough surface of the cast. Next, coming to metallurgical casting defects and causes. These will cause by the pouring metal, by the selection of metal and composition of alloy. All these come under the metallurgical casting defects. Coming to, these are the different types, that is hot tear and hard spots. Coming to hot tear. Hot tear will form. The cracks appear in the form of irregular crevices or branches pattern. Next, some cracks are obvious and easily seen, while other cannot be required magnification. These are very small cracks. Some cracks occur as the casting tools towards the end of the solidification. Next, it is the diagrammatic representation of hot tear crack. Next, coming to causes and prevention of the hot tears. If the solidifying metal does not have sufficient strength to resist the tensile forces during the solidification, that hot tears will be appear. Next, hot tears are mostly caused by the poor mold design. Next, modifying the mold to improve collapsibility can easily resolve these issues. Okay, coming to hot spots or hard spots. Hot spots or spots that are harder than the surrounding area. This is because of the cooling more quickly than the surrounding materials. In some cases, at the point of pouring molten material is higher strength compared to the surrounding material. It will create the hot spots. Hot spots can interfere with the machining and increase to wear. That is, it is the diagrammatic representation of hot spear. These are the two parts. At this parts, the hot spots will form. Next, causes and prevention of hot spots. Hot spots are a direct result of improper cooling practices. There are two potential solutions, that is, to prevent these causes. That is, start by correcting cooling practice. Next, also consider changing the metal chemical composition. Next, pouring casting defects and causes. Pouring metal defects arise during the process of pouring metal into the mold. That is, if you have a pouring metal defect, it will fall into one of these categories, that is cold shot or lap. Misruns are closely related to cold shots. Next, cold shots, slag inclusions, all these come under this category. First, coming to cold shot. Cold shot is a type of surface defect. You will see a line or crack with a round edge on the casting surface. Next, this defect is visible to naked eye, and this results in rejecting the cast as it creates weaker spot observed in this diagram. Here in center, line will form. This line is known as cold shot. This line is formed due to the, suppose if you fill the casting by using two or more number of gates, the edges points of the molten metal will come under at a single point. At that point, the both metals will be the temperature of the starting point material is cool. For that case, this cold shed will form. Okay, next, causes of cold shed. That is, when a molten metal enters the mold from two gates, the streams will meet at the junction. That is, I'll discuss next. Cold shed is usually a result of lack of fluidity of the molten metal or poor design of the gating system. Next, remedies for cold shed. That is, low temperatures. Next, the best way to prevent cold sheds is to increase the fluidity of the molten metal. This can done by using a few ways. That is, optimizing gating system. Next, increase the pouring temperature. Next, improve gas permeability of the mold. Next, coming to misruns are closely related to cold sheds. Okay, that is, misruns occur when the metals metal is too cold or the molten metal cannot reach the edges of the metal. Due to these, the cold shards will form. Observed in the diagram here, the lost edge that is representing in white color is the meson. It is formed due to the molten metal cannot reach the edge surface because the pouring time is high, or it is the end port, or the material have the shape is very thin. These are the different causes of the mesons. Okay, molten metal fluidity. Next, cold shards. Cold shards are formed due to splattering or during the pouring metal. During the pouring of molten metal, some small particles will fall on the molten cavity. These creates a small, that is solid particles in round in shape. Observed in diagram here, small balls like structure form that is in represented in white color, that is known as cold shards. These are the causes to cause and prevention of cold shards, that is modifying pouring procedures. Next, adjusting gating system design. Next, coming to slag inclusion. Slag is nothing but after the preparation or during the preparation or after the preparation, some slag is float on the top surface of molten metal, that is a few mm thickness. A layer is formed, that is unwanted material or unmelted particles is known as slag. During the pouring of molten metal, it enter into the mold cavity. It will cause the slag inclusion, is known as scab. It is the diagrammatic representation of slag. Next, coming to causes and prevention of inclusion. By filtering the slag particles or by using the by mixing the proper flux into the melting process, we can prevent this fraction. Next, coming to casting shape defects and causes. There are mainly two divided into these casting defects, that is shift or mismatch and wrapping. Shift or mismatch is nothing but at the time of molding process, the mold shift, that is the pattern, will shift from the drag and cope box slightly shifted into the side besides the mold. And mold shift is due to misalignment of upper, that is cope and drag box of the mold. Mold shift is usually reflected as a horizontal displacement. Observed in diagram. Here it is known as shift or mismatch due to the defect caused by the at the time of mold preparation. That is, the drag and cope box will slide slightly each other in horizontal way. Next, causes and prevention of shift. That is, some causes, that is loose box pins, inaccurate pattern dowel pins, or carelessness in placing the cope and drop box. These are the different types of defects. That is, coming to wrapping. Wrapping is unwanted casting deformity that can occur over time, which results in a change in dimensions of the final product. It can happen during the after solidification. That is observed in diagram here. Actually, it is in a horizontal shape, but at the time of after the completion of casting process, it will be deformed into dotted lines, that is deflected or deformed into the different shape apart from the required shape, is known as the wrapping. Next, causes and prevention of wrapping. That is, wrapping is typically results of different rates of solidification of different sections, which causes stress in adjoining walls. Large and flat sections are more prone to wrapping. Next, normalizing the heat treatment can remove residual stresses in iron casting. Next, straightening between quench and aging process might also be required for aluminum casting. Okay, these are the different types of casting defects in casting process. Up to now we have finished unit 1, that is casting process. Okay. थैंक यू।